okay, array is very important, right? Sometimes if you get some inputs from keyboard, right, but you need to store it somewhere. For example, for the previous example, if you get, okay, you need, if you want to get the input, right, but input is not just only one input, right, you need to get, okay, maybe the score of the student, maybe start from 70, 80, 65, 90, and so on, right? And then you may end up with zero, right? To end up with your input format. So what you have to do is you can do, you can use do while loop. Okay, this is just an example to get the input, right? Why do you do while until you get input, like correct input number as zero, right? And then sometimes you need to keep this in somewhere, right? Somewhere. But you don't know in advance the number of the exact number of the input, right? So you don't know how to declare, right? Integer, right? You may have to declare integer input one, input two, and so on. As I just said, that it is you don't know in advance about the number of the input. So you may need to know. Or to allocate, we need to use this word, allocate space for your input data. Okay, this is the advantage of how to use array, right? Because array, what does it mean by array? Array is a set or group of contiguous memory location that all have the same type. So you know, normally when you declare integer I, right, it will be I, right, with 4 bytes. So that's all. But if you want to get input, maybe let's say 10 integer, right? And you need to put it in a contiguous or the contiguous memory location, means C0 and C1 need to be the neighbor location, okay, need to be contiguous, okay? So this is the meaning of the array, right? To refer to a particular location, you can use the position number we call index is singular, right? Index is singular. You may use indices, right? That will refer to the position number, right? For array, right? It's very easy to declare an array. You can just maybe, if you want to declare array, you can use array, 10 array of integer, you can just like this. In this way, how can we declare this array? What is the number to put here? We will put 12 here, right? So because there are 12 elements containing 12 elements in this array, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on, 12. Right, but if you want to refer to the first element of array, you need to refer it as index zero, C0. Okay, maybe I have to change this one. If I declare like this, right, so I just use integer C, bracket, square bracket. It will refer to, if you want to refer to the array, you can use the name, array name, and followed by the position number, right? That put in a particular square bracket here. Okay, if I want to get minus 45 from the first element of array, I can refer to it as C0, and that's all. Okay, the first element in every array will be zero, the zeroth element, right? An array name like other variable names can contain only letters, start with the letter and following by digits and underscore, and cannot begin with a digit. Okay, you can just name it as the variable names, as a normal C variable name. Okay, and for the bracket, right, it is the highest precedence. It will be executed first. It will be executed first for array, the highest precedence. Okay. So if you want to define array, I have just told you that you can just simply use int C and bracket 12, and then don't forget semicolon, right? That's all. And if you want to define two integer arrays, you can use B and X, right? And then you can use comma for the delimiter, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, here we come to the array, the first example of how to use array. So we start from the standard.io.h, and then in the main program, right, we declare it as an integer function. And then we declare n, small n is an array of 10 integers. So I put 10 inside this square bracket. Okay, and I declare size t. Size t will be a data type of the number of the byte, or the number of the byte for this particular data type, for the particular variable. Okay, use I as an counter, and then I from 0 to 10, right, you use less than 10, and then you need to set it up as a 0. Okay, once again, similar to the typical integer variables, right, where once you declare it, you need to initialize it. Do you remember? Once you declare it, you need to initialize it. Similar to the array declaration, once you declare an array, you need to set it up. You need to clean it up. For example, because you don't know in advance that before you use this portion or this part of this space, we are located from main memory. We don't know that what will be the value in the previous stage of this memory. So you need to set it up to 0. So I suggest you all, this is not the compulsory, but this is a tradition. For a good programmer, you need to initialize this. For example, if you write a program in the midterm exam or the module exam, right, this is going to come very soon, next week. So what you have to do is after you allocate the memory for array, you need to initialize it. Okay, so this part will be important. Otherwise, if you didn't, you forget to put it in your programs, I will deduct your score. Okay. There's a question. Teacher, so x 10 is like I put 10 empty areas in array. That's right. So if you declare 10, so you will have 10 empty array starting from the index 0 to 9. So the index here will start from 0 to 9. So you print out also, and this program, right, you just want to print out something or the value inside the array, right? Once you initialize it, them all to 0, right? And then you want to print it out. So element 0, I is 0, right? Print value 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, and so on, 2, 9, 0. So this is what we initialize this array to 0. before use every time. Don't forget. Okay, you may put star here. Okay, even this part of the program is will not impact to the output of the program, but you need to initialize it. Uh-huh. Okay, this is to initialize it, but it may be tedious, right? Maybe tedious. Right. So, what shall we do? So, if you want to, okay, maybe sometimes you need to. Deductive score. I means that even these lines, okay, they will not impact to the output of the score, but I need you all to write this part in your program. Always don't forget, write this part always like this part in your program, right? Mm-hmm. The reason is that you don't know how or what, or you don't know the value that was kept before you get this or you allocate this main memory. So you need to create up, I would say that. Mm-hmm. If you forget to put this, even your program completely correct, okay, you may have to get 10, right? But if I see your code, right, if you forget this, maybe your code or your score will be deducted. Mm-hmm. So if you have input array, we don't need to initialize to zero. We need to initialize to zero if you don't know yet about the value. But if you know in advance the value of the array, right? In this example, okay? Please see this. If you know in advance the value of the program, you can initialize it like this. Once you declare it like this, you use equal sign and then braces here, right? This is if you want to initialize it for a particular values, you can use the initializer list like this. Okay, this is a powerful, impressive construct of C programming. You can initialize the value like this. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, if you just want to use that, the short format of the array, you can also use. Mm-hmm. It depends, but I want to make sure that the value, the initialized value will be set to zero, or the garbage will not be will be put. Let's think like this. If you forget to initialize it to be zero, right? When I come back to the previous program, right? To calculate SD, right? SD or standard deviation, you can come up with the wrong result. Mm-hmm. It's just probably a wrong result, but not exactly. But as I just told you, right, it's just a tradition, right? And you need to write the good program, right? I teach you not just only to write C program, but I need you to also write a good program as well. Okay, so in this case, right, so it's now, if you know and in advance the initialized list of the array, right, you can just simply put like this, and then this one to be printed out, right? Okay. What is the result of this program? If you want to initialize the array to the list of events integer from 2 to 20. So it's really easy, right? You can just like this 2 plus 2 multiplied by j, j from 0 to size, okay? And then print out. Easy. Okay, so if you want to sum all elements in array, what shall we do? Okay, suppose I give you this one, right? Okay, maybe in the examination, I will ask you to write the program to do something for the list of array, right? Maybe I have to give you this one. Uh-huh. And then you have to write a program to initialize. Okay, for the easy of scoring or marking your midterm exam, maybe I have to give you the list of the arrays, right? You may have to write a program like this. And then for this example, it asks you to sum array, right? So you need to use this total, right? Total will be the sum of the array, right? Total is equal to total plus ai, right? Array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? You can do for loop, right? Mm-hmm. So for I from 0 to I less than size, and then total, this one is a compound assignment statement, right? So it's equal to total plus AI. So it means that once you have a numbers of elements in array A, right, you need to sum them up and keep the value to available total. Okay, this is what this part does. This piece of course does. Okay, so it's very easy if you want to sum array, right? Sum all elements in the array. Sum of the elements of array. Mm-hmm. Once you get sum, right, you can also get the average, right? How can we get the average of the list here? You see, right? It's not difficult. You can just simply get, if you get the sum, and then you need to know n, right? N will be the number of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, right? And then you can divide it by 12, so you can get the average. Okay, from this program, right? From this program, you can also find average or x bar, and you can also find SD as well. So, if you could remember, today we have lab 3, right? Lab 3, the previous slide, right? And that in that lab, you don't have you don't know array yet, but now you know array. So you can just simply put this one in order to avoid the long sequence of input that you have to input all the times, right? So you may need to put it as an initialized part of the array, and then you can calculate SD, right, from array. And the next example is to calculate the student polls, right, and print the frequency of the polls, right? Okay, if you have time, you can try to write this program and then practice and see it, right? After you get the frequency the rating here, right? So you can also, in order to just show the value to or something, right? Okay, this is the program, right? Rating 1, frequency 2, rating 2, frequency 2, right? So this one is to print the value. But do you remember histogram, right? Suppose you have element here, 0 is 19, right? I want the program to print the histogram, to print 19 asterisks, 3, 1, 2, 3, 15, 7, and so on, right? So If you could remember the statics, statistics course, right? So you need to print out or calculate for the histogram or even for the mean mode or something, right? So you can also write a program to calculate for that. Mm-hmm. Okay, here we come to the, what time is it now? Okay. Oh, here it comes to the, if suppose you want to, okay, to declare arrays, right? Size is 7, right? You want to know the frequency of the, when you roll a dice, right? Oh, 6 million times, right? And you want to count the frequency of the face, right? Of the face we have for the, for one dice. For dice, we have 6 faces, right? We need to know the faces. If we want to know this, you just use the random function, right? To generate the random function to show 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? Just only 6, right? And then we have to count the frequency, right? So in this way, you can just simply, okay, you have to use standard.io.h, standard library, std library, right? L-I-B, stands for, is an abbreviation of the library, and then times, right? We need to use time.h because we want to get the time from the system. We want to get the time from the system. So you need to use time.h. And then when you use s time here, this function, line number 15, right? It will see the random number generator. This seed random number generator means you can generate randomly a new number all the time. If you forget to put this one, right? The program will generate the first random number, the same number or the same random number all the time. And then for the seed function, right? It will, I've not yet talk much about the standard library, but you can check it out about the function inside the standard library.h. In standard library.h, right, if you need to use the srandom or random function, right? For random function, right, random, random function will generate a number, right? And you multiply by 6 here, right? So it will generate the number from 6 to 5, from 0 to 5, and then you need to multiply, to plus 1 to get the number from 1 to 6, which is the faces of the dice. The dice, you know, the dice like this. Okay, and then you have to keep the number that you have to count the number of faces after random. Okay, because you want to count the frequency of the each face that after we dice roll the dice for 6 million time. And then this one, this for loop will generate this table, and that's all. So this one is important. So why we have to use standard library. I don't know, I forget about that because we have to use SRAN. SRAN maybe was defined in this function and maybe random will be in time. I'm not sure about that, but you need to include these two function. Oh, sorry, these two program.h. This is the library. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, before we go to the character array, right? I will pause. Okay, the next topic that I would like to teach you today is about the a good example of how to use array, because right, as we are the C programmer, right, if we want to use a string, sorry, string, right, string is a set of character or a sequence of character, actually. A sequence of character. What does this mean, a sequence of character? Suppose you want to declare a KMUTT string, right? You have to use the double quote in order to represent this string, but we don't have a character, a string, string data type in C programming, right? In C programming, you use array of character instead, but you don't have to put the, it's not necessary to put the number of character inside this. For this example, you want to declare string one, right? This is a set of character or array of character. You can just simply use this, and then you can also initialize it right after your declaration. Like this one, you want to declare it as a first string, right? First string in the string one. So what is the interpretation of this one? You will allocate, right? You will allocate string. This is a name, right? In main memory. In main memory, you will allocate how many characters you will allocate in the memory. For first. For first, because we have 5 characters, so you have to allocate 6 characters. 6 characters. Why? Because you need to allocate F, I, R, S, T, and backslash N. Backslash N, backslash 0 will be a null character. A null character to represent the ending character of this string. Now character is backslash 0. Backslash 0, right? This is character backslash 0. Okay, so you will, okay, backslash 0, right? We call it now character, right? So first there are 5 characters for the first string, right? But you need to allocate one more character, plus the spatial, right? A spatial string termination character we call now character. Okay, so for this one, right? For the explicit declaration of this statement will be string one and then 6 equal to first. Okay, this is a way that we want to store the string character or the string, a string. Okay, a string is a sequence of characters. Because a string is really an array of character, okay, this is again, a string is really an array of character. We can access individual characters in a string directly. Okay, from this example, if you want to access the first element, you can just simply use string one, index 0. So it means the character small f or the string one index 3, it will refer to s, character small s. But if you have not known yet about the size of characters, you may allocate the string a string as it, the possible maximum number of the string. For this example, if you want to allocate maybe the name of the student, right? We use character string 2, right? And we declare 20. So in this way, how many character will be the, how many possible number of characters will can be put in this array or this string 2? 19 characters max. For no error, okay? Because we need to reserve one character for the noun character, the terminating noun character string. Okay, so for the scan if, you want to make sure that you will store at most 19 characters, right? And there is no runtime error. So you can just simply use %19s to get the string from keyboard, okay? For string 2. And the most 19 characters will be put in this variable string 2, okay? Okay, this is an example of how to use a string as a character of array of character, right? For this program, right, you okay enter a string no longer than 19, right? You declare this one size, right? Size 20, and then you get the first string, right? Of the maximum size 19, and then you print out. So when you print string 1, right? This one you get string 1, right, from keyboard, right? And once you see, when you see that if you input hello there, hello and blank and there, right? When you try to print out string 1, right? String 1 is hello. Only hello can be printed out, can be received and keep it and keep and kept in the string 1. And then string 1 with space between character is string 1, string 2. String 2 is when you use this second F, right, even you input hello there, right, but it seems like it will just only print out only the part that is before the space or the blank value, right? When you try to print out string 1, right, only hello can be print out, and string 2 was declared and reserved as a 15 characters string literal, so string literal will be print out, and then string 1 with space, okay, this is just text that can be print out, okay? Once you get the, okay, if you want to print hello like this, like with the space in between each characters, so what you have to do is, in this way, you can just simply print out %C, %C mean print character after character. Right. In this case, string is the character inside the string 1 is hello. Right. So you need to print character percent size C, right? And this one is the blank. This one is to print out just only character. Only one character. Only one character, right? We use string one. String one. And index I, right? So this similar to character. You need to print out character one after another. Okay, if you use this one, this for loop here, right? It will show you hello like this. Okay. And then this one put s, right? Put s is a function to put to write, because it is now something like this, right? To print something, this thing out of the screen and then enter. Put S mean printf bok enter. What does it mean by enter? Enter means backslash n. Once again, put S is equal to print something inside the function and then plus backslash n. Okay, I think this sounds one the explanation or the introduction of how to use a string as an array of character, and we will talk about the string and how to compare string, how to use function of the string later. Okay, so here we come to the last session that is important, but once again, this one is not included in the first module, examination. So you don't have to worry about this. You can just simply know how to use just only one dimensional array. That's all. But multi-dimensional array will be in the second module. Okay, but today I just want to give you some introduction of a multi-dimensional array. Because we have the array just like the vector, sometimes we can say just only one-dimensional array is just a vector. It's just a vector. For example, why I call that? Because I can write this like this. It's like a vector, right? 1, 2, 4, 6, something like this, right? This is like a vector. But sometimes you may need to, like for example, in the big data applications or the maybe data science applications, you may have to use the many dimensions of the data or the very, very big data. You may have to store the data in the Excel files, right? And Excel files can be represented as more or less like a multi-dimensional array or two-dimensional arrays. So in fact, in the real world application, 2D, two-dimensional array is very important. So, but we can generalize it to be the multi-dimensional arrays. Okay, but for the sake of simplicity, right, I will start from just talking about a two-dimensional array. When we talk about two-dimensional array, we have to refer to it as a row and column. Row will be like this, row one, row two, row three, right? But if you refer to the index in C, right, you have to start from row zero, row one, row two, okay? Row will be the first element in the index. And the column zero, one, column two, column three will be the second index. Okay, if I want to declare this one, right? We have three rows, four columns, right? So I have to declare it as, this one will be integer A, because we know that there are two dimensions, right? So we have three rows four columns. So the first element will be the number of the rows of the array, and the second will be referred to columns of the array. Okay, so this is general, right? So in this way, we have three rows, four columns. The index starting from 0 to 2 and 0 to 3. Please remember that. We can use a multi-dimensional array in the case of if you want to access or if you want to find the matrix addition, right? We have two rows, three columns. We want to add up, right? You have to represent it in terms of the multi-dimensional array or two-dimensional array, okay? Or you want to find determinant matrix, determinant student score. They are also can represent in terms of the multi-dimensional array. Mm-hmm. These are some examples of how to use the multi-dimensional array. Okay, and similarly to the case of the multi-dimensional array, right? You can also initialize it. Okay, for this example, if you declare it as matrix of array B 2, 2, right? 2 means 2 rows, 2 columns. Okay, you may have to use the bases, right? For one dimensional array, you use one basis, right? And for two dimensional, you can use two bases like this, the inner bases, I would say that, right? For inner bases, you can use 1, 2, right? And 3, 4. So from this one, right, it will be shown as the array like this. Where do you put one? One will be here, right? Because this one is 0, 0, index 0, 0, row 0, column 0. This one will be row 0, column 1. This one will be 1, column, row 1, column 0, row 1, column 1. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4. Everyone, if you remember with comments in the chat box, right, that is the initialization integer A10, like this, is equal to 0. This one is a shorter format for initialize all elements in this array A, right? For 10 elements, it will be set up as 0 or 0. For this case as well, right? Suppose you declare or initialize this one to be 1, right? So what does it mean? It means that normally it should be this will be 1 and 1, something like this. Because we have known in advance that because B is 2, 2, right? And this one is supposed to be two elements like this, but you just like it just only 1, so it will be equal to 1, 1. Okay, so B 0, 0 is equal to 1, B 0, 1 is equal to, oops. B 0, 1 is equal to 0. Really? You may have to check it out. Okay, from this one, sorry, I'm not sure about this because I never used this one. Okay, but this will be from this one will be set to zero, right? If you set like this one, so the last will be zero. I'm not sure. Maybe I will check it out. I will check for you and then I will tell you. Okay, no problem. Okay, so this is a multi-dimensional array initialization. And the next one is how to set the value in the multi-dimensional array, right? This one is a function print array, right? We have not yet talked about function. We are going to talk about this later in the next module. Function, no problem. But in this case, I want to show you, okay, because this one is a main program, right? You can initialize array like this, right? And then, okay, it's quite sure, right? If this is 2, 3, right? This is 1, 2, and this is 4. So it will be 1, 2, 0, and then 4, 0, 0. So it means that, okay, it will be 0. If you didn't initialize it, it will set to 0 automatically. Okay, so from this one, if it complete initialize, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But if in this case, you can also declare it as a linear, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 0. Interesting. And then for this one, right, if you declare just only 1, 2, and 4, it will be 1, 2, 0, and 4, 0, 0. Okay, this is a good example. It is interesting. And then, okay, similar to the case of the array, the single dimensional array, right? You can also initialize it in the form of the for loop, right? You can use for loop in order to initialize it one by one, right? You can also do that, okay? Or you don't want to write for, you can just individually set it up or initialize it, no problem, okay? But this one is, I don't suggest you to do so, you have to write program. And if you want to sum them all, right, you can simply use for loop and outer loop and for loop. For row from 0 to 2 and column from 0 to 3. And then you use total once again plus equal, right? It will equal to total is equal to total plus a row and column. And that's all. They will sum all of the elements in the two-dimensional array. Okay, this is a net statement. Okay, that's good. Mm-hmm. So today we have already started about review. I will review about the nested loop, right? That is about to create a pyramid and many patterns. And also we end up with the Pascal triangle and also how to calculate for the standard deviation. And then I will focus teaching you about the array, and then I give you some example of array string, and then the last one will be the multi-dimensional array. This is the end of today's lesson. Do you have any questions? Please feel free to ask me. But I also have